Hello everybody, and welcome to the next installment in our Corona Physical Material series. In this one, we'll be focusing all of our attention on the Sheen Layer, which is a new feature that got introduced with the new physical material, and it makes creating that realistic sheen effect a ton easier and, well, a lot quicker as well. So that's what we'll be focusing our attention on in this one. And before we go in and we start fiddling with all the cool parameters and whatnot, let's just do a really quick breakdown of the scene we'll be working in. So as you can see, we're in this living room type of an interior, and the main star of the show for us here is going to be the sofa, which has this fabric material applied to it, to which we're going to add that realistic sheen effect. Now, as for the fabric material itself, we've got it opened right in front of us here in the Slate Node Editor. And as you can see, it's a really simple, but still good looking material. We've got a basic fabric texture that's driving the whole thing, and it's being plugged into this composite map because we're adding some slight imperfections to it in the form of this imperfection map. Now, we're doing that by simply multiplying the imperfection map on top of the fabric texture. And that is what is adding some nice slight detail to our base layer, which, you know, just adds some extra realism because imperfections are everywhere in the real world and no material is 100% clean. All right, then to wrap up the breakdown, we've got a basic fabric looking bump map plugged into the bump map slot in our material. And that really is all that there is to it. The material is looking great, as you can see, but it is missing that nice and realistic sheen effect that will just make it look all the more convincing. So that's the breakdown. Now let's focus on the sheen layer itself. The sheen effect is that nice, kind of like a highlight looking effect, but not quite, that happens on certain materials, especially if those materials are a little fuzzy or hairy. And the effect is typically more apparent if you look at those materials from the more grazing angles. And our sofa render here is a pretty good example of that behavior. Now, the sheen effect is most commonly associated with fabric materials because typically those produce the most apparent effect. But that said, it's not just limited to fabric materials. You can see it on other objects or materials as well, such as, for example, peaches or kiwis as well. And just as an FYI, this kiwi image you see is a Corona rendered image, just so you know. Right, and so the sheen effect is present on a couple of different real world materials. And how it comes to be in the real world is you have a gazillion of microstrands or microparticles even that are sticking out of your objects, out of your materials. And these microstrands or particles are so tiny that all they basically do, visually speaking, is they catch highlights. And so that's what you perceive as the sheen effect. In the CG world, it would make very little sense to scatter a ton of micro things on your objects because that would slow things down. And so the way things are done in the virtual world is by simulating that effect through your actual materials. Now, with the new Corona physical material, to get the sheen layer going, all you need to do is you need to enable it by upping its amount parameter to anything above zero. And just like that, you'll get that nice and realistic sheen effect going. If we take a look at our rendered image, well, you'll notice that the sheen effect is really quite noticeable, and it really adds a lot to our fabric material here. I mean, we don't even have to do A and B comparisons here because the difference is that huge, as you can see. Obviously though, the sheen effect is not always the same strength. It might have a pattern to it, or whatever the case may be really, you'll eventually want to customize it to replicate the material you're trying to recreate. So let's take a look at the parameters that you have available to you to tweak. So first up, we have the amount parameter. And with it, as you can imagine, we control the intensity of the sheen effect. With the parameter set to 1.0, the sheen effect is at its strongest possible intensity. And if we set it to, say for example, 0.2, well then the sheen effect will be a lot less intense, as you can see. Now, obviously, what you'll want to do with this parameter is you're going to want to adjust it according to the material that you're trying to recreate. What's really cool about it, though, is that you can plug a bitmap or a procedural map even into it, which you can use to add some extra realism to your material. Because if you take a look at our sheen effect right now, you're going to notice that it's quite uniform, sort of even across the board, if you will. And in reality, somebody would probably touch or sit on the sofa, which would trample some of those micro strands, right? And those parts would then have a less intense sheen effect to them. Because, you know, if the strands are sticking out, then the sheen effect will probably be more intense than it would be if you've sat on a part of a sofa, which would flatten those strands, and then they wouldn't catch as many highlights like that. So we have a bit of an imperfection map prepared here. Let's just scoot it over. And it's just a regular imperfection map. It just has this dirt and grime on it in black and white form. And so now what we're going to do here is we're going to plug this map into the sheen amount slot. And just like that, as you can see, we've added realistic details to our sheen effect, because now certain parts are less sheeny than others. And that's probably how this kind of a sofa would look like once it was in a room and people actually sat on it and kind of moved those micro strands around a bit, right? Right. Now, the effect might be a little too strong. So what we'll do next here is we'll adjust how much of that imperfection map we're mixing into our sheen amount slot. So we'll go into our materials properties, and we're going to scroll all the way down here, and we'll just set the mixing coefficient to 50 or so. And so now that imperfection map is going to be affecting our sheen amount quite a bit less than it did before. But as you can see, it's still there, and it just adds that nice realism to it all, right? Because now that effect is not too exaggerated, and it looks, well, even more realistic because of it. Okay, so that's how you use the amount parameter in your sheen layer. So let's move on to the next parameter, and so let's talk about roughness next here. So roughness basically defines how rough the sheen effect will be. You can also sort of think about it in terms of how wide the sheen effect is. So if we, for example, up the roughness parameter here to say 0.7, you're going to notice in the material preview that the sheen effect is, well, just a lot rougher, a lot wider now, and it sort of encompasses more of the material. It's not just there on those grazing angles anymore. And the same thing happened in the interactive renderer as well, as you can see, right? Now, if we were to lower the roughness down to, say, 0.05, well, now you're going to see that the sheen effect will be a lot less rougher, a lot more narrower, if you will. And so it'll only be visible on those grazing angles, right? Right. Now, the way you want to set this parameter, obviously, again, depends on the type of material you're trying to recreate. Typically, though, I personally tend to find that I like to stick to values between 0.2 or 0.4 or somewhere in between for most of the fabric materials that I'm creating myself. So that might be a solid starting point for you as well. But again, it totally depends on the type of material you're trying to recreate. For our generic fabric material here, let's just go with a value of 0.3. All right, so then there's only one more parameter left, and that is the color parameter. And as you might have guessed, with the color parameter, you're controlling the color of the sheen effect. You want your sheen to be red? Well, set your sheen color to red, and your sheen is now red. Typically, for your common fabrics, if you want that slight extra touch of realism, what you can do is you can sample the base color of your material, and then you can just make it a lot less saturated. And our material here is already pretty much desaturated as it is, but sometimes for that extra realism, you just want to have a slight hint of color in there. So maybe you just have a couple of percentage points of that saturation, if not even less than that. So something super slight. And we'll probably want to up the value to its fullest, just so we retain that bright and noticeable sheen look. And so depending on the type of a material that you're trying to recreate, that's one of the potential use cases for the color parameter. That said, the color parameter can be of crucial importance if you're trying to recreate a velvet looking material. So we're starting from blank here. We just have a basic Corona physical material, and we're going to create a super basic velvet material real quick here, and we're going to leverage the sheen layer to do that. First off though, let's give our non-metal material here a base color. So we're going to go under the base layer and we're going to input a color. Now we're going to go with a purplish color here. You can go with whatever color you prefer, obviously, but we're just going to input this purplish or violetish color, okay, however you want to call it, okay? All right, now a velvet material has a pretty distinct sheen effect to it. So what we're going to do next here is we're just going to enable the sheen layer. And so now you can already kind of see a cool looking effect that's making our material look kind of velvety. But what we'll need to do here to get a more proper velvet look is we'll need to set a more proper color for the sheen color. All right, so let's sample that base color. Okay, so just like that. And now with velvet materials, typically, not always, but typically, the sheen color is lighter and more desaturated looking compared to the base color. So what we're going to do here is we're just going to lower the saturation quite considerably here, and we're going to up the value a little bit. Okay, there we go. Okay, so then I think what we could do next here is we could up the roughness by just a little bit. Maybe we can up it to a value of 0.4. And I think this looks velvety enough for us. And so just like that, as you can see, we've created some sort of a nice looking basic velvet material. Now, could you further tweak things? Well, yes, of course you could. You could add more details to it all. You could add imperfections to the color. You could add imperfections to the amount, and so on and so forth. At this point, you're just being creative and you're trying to hone in on those details. Now, as far as this tutorial goes, this is basically a wrap. So hopefully you've learned how to use the sheen layer. Hopefully you've noticed just how easy the sheen effect is to set up with the Corona physical material. And we hope you're inspired to go and create sheeny materials on your own. Thank you for tuning in. And until next time, take care, everybody.